This video is about OneDrive sync icons. When you go to File Explorer on Windows or Mac, next to the file, you will see status icon. These are the icons we are going to learn. Whenever you see a person, that means this file is shared. If you don't see a person, that means the file is not shared. It's accessible only to you. The first one is the syncing icon. What does that mean? I created a file, stored it on OneDrive, but first it gets stored on my local PC and then it is synchronizing with the cloud. So that is what it is indicating. When the sync is complete, the tick mark will come, the green tick mark. Green tick mark means the file is on PC and on cloud, all good. Third one is the white tick mark. File is on PC and cloud, but there is a difference. Watch till the end to understand the difference. The cloud icon means the file is not there on the local drive. It is there only on the cloud. Now let's talk about editing. Which files can you edit when you don't have internet connection? If the file is synchronizing, you already have internet connection, so no question there. Green and white tick mark means the file is on local drive. So of course you can edit offline. Only if it is a cloud icon, the file is physically not present. You're only seeing the file name. So if you're offline, it's going to give you an error and you cannot edit offline. If you have internet connection, you see a file with cloud icon and double click on it, the file will download and then you can open the file and edit it. If you go back and look at the icon of the file, what will happen? Now the file icon changed to green tick mark because the file did get downloaded. That's called file on demand. By the way, the icons have the exact same meaning for folders as well. So let's understand, where is it occupying space? While it is synchronizing, it may be occupying space on cloud or PC, depending on from where it is getting synchronized. But once it is done, that means the icon changes to green or white tick mark, then it is occupying space on both sides, local drive and cloud. In case of cloud icon, it is not occupying space on the local drive, only on the cloud. Remember, cloud has lots of space, whereas local drives always have shortage of space. So only the active files or folders, projects which are ongoing, those files I want on local drive because I may want to work on them offline. Otherwise, let them be on the cloud. I want to save space locally. Let's take an example. Let's assume this was a very large file and I wanted to not occupy space locally because that job is done. I don't want to delete the file. Please don't delete the file, because if you do that, it's going to get deleted from local drive and from cloud and all other devices. So I don't want to delete. So what I want to do is right click and choose free up space. That means it's like telling OneDrive, I don't want it to occupy space locally, but you keep your copy. So it'll again go into sync mode. Once that is done, the icon will change from whatever it was earlier to a cloud icon. To understand what happened, right click on the file and look at the properties. You'll see that the size is 14 KB, but size on local drive is 0. And that's exactly what free up space means. The reverse is also true. Let's say this project was on hold and that's why I've made it into a cloud icon. That means free up space. But now the project is active, so I want all the files in that folder to be available all the time. One option is to go to that folder, go to each file, double click, and then the file will convert from cloud to green tick mark. But that I'll have to do for so many files. I don't want to do that. So I can select a folder or select multiple files, right click on that and say always keep on this device. Now what is going to happen? All the files will start getting white tick mark. There's another situation where this is very useful. I'm going to conduct a Power BI training for a customer and they are going to go on an offsite in a very remote location where internet is not guaranteed. It's a long flight and these sample files which I'll use for the training, I will edit during the flight and I also want those files during the training program. So what do I do? While I have the internet, right click and choose always keep on this device. Let it do its job and then I board the flight. So that is what I call plan for working offline when you are online. Many people have suffered because of not understanding this part clearly. I'm sure it has happened to you. Suddenly the disk space is low, machine is crawling, and you don't know what to do. In panic mode, you randomly go and delete some stuff and then realize, oh, that was very important and I don't have a backup for it. That is a thing of past, because Windows has an amazing option called Storage Sense. Go to System, go to Storage Sense and enable it. By default, it wakes up when there is low disk space. Exactly how much disk space is not fully documented, but somewhere around 5 to 10% free space. Make it run every week or month, depending on how frequently you manage files. Now, how does it work? Well, it deletes recycle bin. You can decide unused files up to 60 days. Similarly, downloads folder, we keep downloading and forget about it. Again, files which have not been used for last 30 days will be deleted. And then the most important part is locally available cloud content. What does that mean? The files which are currently green tick mark, that means they are occupying space locally, but you have not used that file for 60 days. So most probably it's not really important to you. So it's going to convert it to a cloud only file automatically. Of course, files which are always keep on this device will not be touched. The staleness of file can be defined on a per OneDrive or SharePoint or Teams sync basis. And most probably, you will never run out of disk space suddenly ever. I'm sure you found this useful. Start using it, share it with as many people as you can. And to continue to become more efficient, subscribe to the channel, click the bell icon, put comments, ask questions, learn, work smarter, and grow faster. So that's it for now. See you next time. Thank you.